Hello students, this is Shri Sudha Kembhavi. I welcome you all to this video lecture series on social media analytics. So in the previous video, I had told you about why do we need to do network measures and what is centrality. And I had also explained you about degree centrality. So the problem with degree centrality is that the centrality is measured on basis of the number of neighbors that the node has. The high number of neighbors, the high centrality, right? But this is always not true. Meaning, if you have more number of friends, it does not always mean that you are influential person, right? Having more number of friends does not guarantee that the person is important. So this is the problem with degree centrality. And how do we overcome this degree centrality problem with eigenvector centrality? So what does this eigenvector centrality does is it generalizes the degree centrality by taking the importance of the neighbors as well. Okay, it considers how important the neighbor is for a node and then calculates its centrality. In simple words, my centrality will depend or will be calculated by taking into consideration my friend's centrality as well. Okay, this is about eigenvector centrality. So in undirected graph, we will take into account all the neighbors of the nodes. So let us assume that eigenvector centrality of a node is Ci of Vi. For node Vi, the centrality is Ce of Vi. So when my neighbors are important, right? When my neighbors are important, my importance is also increased, right? This is what the assumption is of eigenvector centrality. So what we want is, we want Ce of Vi to be higher when important neighbors, right? If Vj is my neighbor and if Vj is important, then my importance should also be increased. So for incoming neighbors, we will assume that Aji is equal to 1. So how do we formulate this example? The assumption that we have made is the centrality of me is proportional to centrality of my neighbor. So this is how we formulate this scenario in this formula. So since I am assuming that it is proportional, I will give it a summation bound with some fixed constant called as lambda. So Ce of Vi, centrality of node Vi, will be equal to 1 upon lambda summation of j equals 1 to n Aji Ce of Vj. So centrality of Vi will be equal to 1 by lambda times of all the centralities of its neighbors. This is what this formula is telling. Okay. So if I assume that centrality is a vector matrix like this, then I can give the formula as lambda Ce is equal to At of Ce, where if you see here, At is adjacency matrix here. Okay. So this means that C is an eigenvector of adjacency matrix At and lambda is its corresponding eigenvalue. So now the question arises, which eigenvalue and eigenvector pair should we choose, right? So to answer this question, we have Perron-Frobenius theorem, which says that for all the positive real number matrix, if there is a matrix of n cross n, and if all its values, if all the values in a matrix are all positive, then there exists eigenvector and eigenvalue, which is given by lambda max. So this lambda max, the highest lambda eigenvector, will be chosen as our eigenvector and eigenvalue. So how do we compute this eigenvector centrality of matrix adjacency matrix A? So first we compute the eigenvalues of A, and we will select the largest eigenvalue lambda among all the calculated eigenvalues, and then we will find the corresponding eigenvector of lambda, which we will store it in CE. That will be our initial centrality, and based on Perron-Fabernois theorem, all components of C will be positive, right? So these components of C will be eigenvector centralities for the graph. Let's see an example here. We have a graph with three nodes. Its adjacency matrix looks like this, and then we have the formula to calculate eigenvector centrality, which is given by lambda CE is equal to ACE. So this we can reformulate in this way, and then we will assume that CE is equal to U1, U2, U3, and then let's just put the values in the formula. So if we rewrite the formula, this is how it will look like, and then we will find the determinant of this matrix. How do you find determinant of the matrix? If you take this particular value, you ignore its row and its column, and you do the diagonal multiplication subtracted by its other diagonal multiplication, and then minus the second value, ignore these two, multiply these diagonal matrix and subtract them together. Same way with this. So I hope you know how to calculate the determinant of the matrix. With that, you will get this equation. So with this equation, when we calculate, we will get the eigenvalues as minus square root of 2, 0, and plus square root of 2. So based on the theorem, we will take the highest lambda value here, which is square root of 2, right? And we will replace this largest eigenvalue in the formula, and this is how it looks like now. So with this eigenvalue, the centralities that we have got is 1 by 2, root 2 by 2, and 1 by 2. If you can see, node V1 and V3 has same centrality values. Let's look at another example. So our lambda values here are 2.68, minus 1.74, minus 1.27, 0.33, and 0.00. And we have to choose the highest eigenvalue here, which is 2.68. So with this largest lambda value, we have got the centralities as shown here. So this is another example of eigenvector centrality. I hope you have understood. I'll just summarize everything to you. So the problem with the degree centrality was, it was directly assuming that if a person has more number of friends, it means he has the highest importance, but that is not true. So the importance of a person increases as his neighbor is important. This is the assumption that we are making in the eigenvector centrality. So the centrality of node is proportional to the centrality of its neighbors. So this is the whole summarization of the eigenvector centrality. So next we will move to CAD's centrality. So the major problem with eigenvector centrality is when it deals with the directed graphs, right? When it deals with the directed graphs, so the centrality is only passed to the outgoing edges, right? Only when there are outgoing edges, the centrality is passed to its neighbors. And in some special cases, when node is a direct acyclic graph, centrality becomes zero even though many edges are connected to it. So this problem has to be handled. So this problem is handled by CAD centrality. And how is it handled by CAD centrality? By adding a extra term, which is beta, which we call as bias term. In the same eigenvector formula, we will add a extra term which is called as bias term. Okay, this is how it handles the problem which is occurring in eigenvector centrality. Right, see, the formula is same as eigenvector centrality. The only additional term that we are adding is the bias beta. So we have two extra terms here, that is alpha, which is called as controlling term, and we have beta, which is bias term in CAD centrality. So we'll rewrite this equation in a vector form. So beta 1, where 1 is vector of all the 1s, and CAD centrality formula looks like this now. So C CADs of Vi is given by alpha summation of j equals 1 to n, meaning for all the neighbors of Vi, Aji is adjacency matrix, and C CADs of Vj plus beta, which is bias term. So when alpha is 0, the eigenvector centrality is removed, and all the neighbors will get the same centrality value beta. So as alpha gets larger, the effect of beta is also reduced. So in practice, we select alpha such that alpha is the largest eigenvalue of adjacency matrix. So here we have an example. So eigenvalues of this particular adjacency matrix is -1.68, -1.0, -1.0, 0.35 and 3.32. Since 3.32 is the highest eigenvalue that we have, we will take 1 upon 3.32 as our alpha value, and let's assume our beta value is 0.2, our bias term value is 0.2. So with this, we get this CAD centrality value by computing. These are the values we get for all the nodes. V1 gets the value 1.14, V2 gets the value 1.31, V3 1.31, V4 1.14, V5 0.85. So here 1.31, 1.31, that is V2 and V3 are the most important nodes in the graph. So the we will discuss about page rank centrality in the next video. It will handle the problem of CAD centrality.